Alright, let's continue playing Undertale. Alright. Might as well go meet, Undyne. The waterfall. See ya. By the way, do I need like recovery items I stored in a box? Other than the butterscotch pot, I won't use it though. Oops, I didn't mean to deny. Oh well. There you are.
Oh, the human arrives! Are you ready to hang out with Undyne? I have a plan to make you two great friends!
You hang out? Sure.
Okay, stand behind me! Psst. Make sure to give her this! She loves these!
Oh, hi. Hi, Papyrus. Ready for your extra private one-on-one training?
You bet I am! And I brought a friend!
Hi, I don't think we've... Why don't you two come in? Alright.
Here, Undyne! My friend brought a gift for you, on their own!
Thanks. I'll put it with the others. Alright! Sorry, ready to start.
Whoopsie doopsie, I just remembered. I had to go to the bathroom. You two have fun.
And he just breaks the windows. So why are you here? To rub your victory in my face? To humiliate me even further? Is that it? No? Then why are you here? Wait, I get it. You think that I'm gonna be friends with you, huh? Right? Yes. Really? How delightful. I accept. Let's all frolic in the fields of friendship. Not. Why would I ever be friends with you? If you weren't my house guest, I'd beat you up right now. You're the enemy of everyone's hopes and dreams. I will never be your friend. Now get out of my house.
Dang, what a shame. I thought Undyne could be friends with you. But I guess... I overestimated her. She's just not up to the challenge.
Challenge? What? Papyrus, wait a second. Darn it. You think I can't be friends with you? Boo-hoo-hoo, what a joke. I could make friends with a wimpy loser like you any day. I'll show him. Listen up, human. We're not just going to be friends. We're going to be... besties! I'll make you like me so much, you won't be able to think of anyone else. Boo-hoo-hoo. It's the perfect revenge. Why don't you have a seat? Alright, fine. Sit down in progress? Sure. Comfortable? I'll get you something to drink. All set. What would you like? Hey, don't get up. You're the guest. Sit down and enjoy yourself. Why not just point to what you want? You can use the spear. Let's get drunk and drink some soda. Oh, soda. Actually, even though you pointed to it, you don't look happy. Hey, that's fine. I think soda's gross too. It rots your teeth. It rots your mind. It rots your fighting spirit. Huh? Why do I have it? Aww. Alright, let's have some hot chocolate. Oh, you want some hot chocolate? Wait, I just remembered. That container's empty. I I stopped getting it because it was always a hassle. Asgore kept getting marshmallows stuck in his beard. Ah, lame. That's the sugar for the tea. I'm not gonna give you a cup of sugar. What do I look like? The ice cream woman? Do human ice cream women terrorize humanity with energy spheres? Are there ice cream songs to a prelude to destruction? Is that it? No? That's what I thought. Are you hitting on me? Oh boy. Ah, whatever. I guess I gotta pick the tea box. I didn't pick the other three, but oh well. Tea, huh? Coming right up. It'll take a moment for the water to boil. Alright. Okay, it's all done. Here we are. Careful, it's hot. It's not that hot, just drink it already. Take a sip of the tea. It's burning. But other than that, it's pretty good. It's pretty good, right? Nothing but the best for my absolutely precious friend. Hey, you know, it's kind of strange you chose that tea. Golden flower tea. That's Asgore's favorite kind. Actually, now that I think about it, you kind of remind me of him. You're both total weenies. Sort of. You know, I was a pretty hothead kid. Once, to prove I was the strongest, I tried to fight Asgore. Emphasis on tried. I couldn't land a single blow on him. And worse, the whole time, he refused to fight back. I was so humiliated. Afterwards, he apologized and said something goofy. Excuse me, do you want to know how to beat me? I said yes, and from then on, he trained me. One day during practice, I finally knocked him down. I felt bad, but he was beaming. I had never seen someone more proud to get their butt kicked. Anyway, long story short, he kept training me, and now I'm the head of the Royal Guard. So I'm the one who gets to train dorks to fight, like a papyrus. But, to be honest, I don't know if I can even ever let Papyrus into the Royal Guard. Don't tell him I said that. He's just, well, I mean, it's not that he's weak. He's actually pretty freaking tough. It's just that he's too innocent and nice. I mean, look, he was supposed to capture you, and he ended up being friends with you instead. I could never send him into battle. He'd get ripped into little smiling shreds. That's part of why I started teaching him how to cook, you know? So, maybe he can do something else with his life. Oh, sorry. I was talking for so long. You're out of tea, aren't you? I'll get you some more. Wait a second. Papyrus, his cooking lesson. He was supposed to have that right now. And if he's not here to have it, you'll have to have it for him. Okay. That's right. Nothing has brought Papyrus and I closer than cooking. Which means that if I give you his lesson, we'll become closer than you can ever imagine. Woohoo, afraid we're gonna be best friends. Let's start with the sauce. Envision these vegetables as your greatest enemy. Now, pound them in the dust with your fist. Let's do it, Wimpy. Cut the best one in an affectionate manner. Oh my god, stop petting the enemy! I'll show you how it's done! Nyah! Alright! We'll just grate this into a bowl later. But for now... Alright! We had the noodles. Homemade noodles are the best. But I just buy store brand! They're the cheapest! Nyah! Just pet them in the pot. Put them in the pot. How you put them in? Fiercely, careful. Place the noodles in one at a time. They clank against the empty bottom. Nice. Alright, now it's time to stir the pasta. As a general rule of thumb, the more you stir, the better it is. Ready? Let's do it. Alright. She likes it doing it harder. Let me do it. Alright. Boo-hoo-hoo-hoo. That's the stuff. Alright, now for the final step. Turn up the heat. Let the stovetop symbolize your passion. Let your hopes and dreams turn into burning fire. Ready? Don't hold anything back. Alright. He likes it hotter. Oh my god, this guy even harder. Wait, that's too- It was too hot to handle. Alright. Ah, man, no wonder Papyrus sucks at cooking. Heck? Oh, whatever. So what's next? Scrapbooking? Friendship bracelets? Oh, who am I kidding? I really screwed this up, didn't I? I can't force you to like me, human. Some people just don't get along with each other. I understand if you feel that way about me. And if we can't be friends, that's okay. Because if we're not friends, it means I can destroy you without regret. Uh-oh. I've been defeated. My house is in shambles. I even failed to befriend you. That's it. I don't care. You're my guest anymore. One final rematch. All out on both sides. It's the only way I can regain my lost pride. Now come on. Hit me with all you got. Nah. Return to swinging out and done with all your might. Bleh. One damage. What? That's the best you can manage? Even attacking at full force, you just can't muster any intent to hurt me, huh? Heh, you know what? I don't actually want to hurt you either. At first, I hated your stupid saturating stick, but the way you hit me right now, it reminded me of someone I used to train with. Now I know you aren't just some wimpy loser. You're a wimpy loser with a big heart, just like him. Listen, human, it seems that you and Asgard are fated to fight, but knowing him, he probably doesn't want to. Talk to him. I'm sure you can persuade him to let you go home. Eventually, some mean human will fall down here, and I'll take their soul instead. That makes sense, right? Foo-hoo-hoo. Oh, and if you do hurt Asgard, I'll take the human soul, cross the barrier, and beat the hell out of you. That's what friends are for, right? Foo-hoo-hoo. Now let's get the hell out of this flaming house. Alright. Well, that was fun, huh? We'll have to hang out again another time, but somewhere else, I guess. In the meantime, I guess I'll go hang with Papyrus. So if you need me, drop by Snowden, okay? Oh, and if you ever need help, just give Papyrus a ring, okay? Since we're in the same spot, I'll be able to talk too. Well, see you later, punk. Bye. Alright. Sounds like only fire lives here now. Alright. Alright, let's go to Hotland. Sure, we're gonna go to Hotland. I already went to Tammy Village, so whatever. Bye. No determination. Sorry, Undyne like told us there was totally a human in the area, so like us royal guards are blocking out the elevators for now. Yeah, even the elevators aren't working anyway. We'll do our best, Miss Undyne. Alright. Guess I'll be heading to the lab. And getting monitored. Oh, my god. I didn't expect you to show up so soon. I haven't showered.